We don't have any resources with us now. Yeah, unless you have something. Do you have something with you? Yeah, we don't have anything. We don't have an appointment with him, right? That's Majek Fashek. Listen to my man, Majek Fashek. Chief Ado, back in the building. A chief with so much swag. Yeah. I can do that. I can put my legs in my office. Relax, got a double shift. Spray some perfume. Look good. Smell good.
Initiative to make Edo great is to showcase young Edo talents who are doing great. Influence Akaba is currently in UK doing his world tour. My man Osamendi in Dublin will be going to Dublin. He will also be going to Italy and so many other countries. Okay. A very, very good afternoon to you. My name remains Dion Osage, Chief Ado, Double Chief. Double Chief Ado, a random acts of kindness initiator. We have been able to show the world a perfect example of what love should be. We have been able to show the world that kindness is possible in Nigeria. You see, Nigeria is a very, very blessed country with so many resources, but our people are not given a fair chance to reach their full potential. I watched on social media, I saw the CEO of ARIC who went to South Africa to bring many young people back home. I think that's a laudable project and I want to say a very big thank you to him for doing that. This is the same country where we have so many politicians, we have pastors who have private jets, they have not been able to contribute to the development of the country. I will continue to join those people who are activists against injustice for our people, man. Will it be wrong if every big church in Nigeria creates just one free school? Can't they do it? In Edo State alone, we have over 100 women's church. Over 100 in Edo State alone. Will it be wrong if winners say, okay, this is free school? Will it be wrong if winners create a farm project, create employment for their members, create it for your members? We have solved many cases here at our office of members of different churches. They come to our office, we solve their case. These are churches with so many billions. We'll continue to speak our mind, our opinion. You don't have to like it. You don't have to like my opinion. Your opinion is your opinion. Keep it to yourself. My opinion is my opinion. It's my opinion and I believe in it. All right? So just a few days ago, we were watching some videos on social media. Eddie Murphy, our good brother. We're going to get to that. Before I proceed, I want to say thank you so much for each and every one of you who continue to support our dream. It's a dream come true for me that we are able to make an impact. We have been able to make a great impact for our people, man. We have been able to make a very, very big impact for our people. And I cannot thank you enough for those of you who believe in the cause, who believe that together we can make a difference. A big shout out to the Esama of Benin Kingdom. The Esama is one of the greatest men in Benin Kingdom. He is my role model because 7 years ago, when I visited the Esama 7 years ago with my organization, he gave us 20,000 naira. The Esama of Benin gave us 20,000 naira 7 years ago. That is because he believed in the youth. The Esama is the first black man to own a Boeing jet. Esama is the first black man to own a private university in Nigeria. Alright? So when people look at the Esama and try to tie Lucky Gbenedion with Esama, it's wrong. You cannot judge a father because of the crime of his son. Esama was already a billionaire before Lucky became a governor. You understand? So for me, Esama remained a great man. I want to say a very, very happy birthday to you, sir. And also a very happy birthday to Benson, Ak Benson Idahosa, whose birthday is also today. I think today or yesterday. Happy birthday to you, sir. May you continue to rest in peace. You are the father of Pentecostal churches. You are the papas of all papas. I wonder if you were alive, you would be happy to see many of your papas, what they are doing these days. They own 5, 6, 7 private jets, not able to give back to the community. We think it's a big failure, a very, very big failure. And we are against it. So we love what your children are doing. Let me open it. I love Faith. Faith Idahosa, she's doing an amazing job. You know, to me, I really think that any church that will the church to his son or to the wife is not a good church. Because as a church, we cannot do that. All right? We cannot do that. Okay. As a church, we cannot continue to do it like a family business. Alright? I am a pastor. When I die, I position my son to take over from where I stop. No, it's not right. So if that's the kind of church you attend, you need to have a rethink. You understand? I'm not supposed to be in the office today, but I'm here because I have some meetings that I need to attend. And we are completing the project of Aduan Primary School in Wonder Local Government. That project is already completed, but we are going to do the official opening on Monday. We have been able to remove the roof, remove all the ceilings, fix the classrooms, the new board, 100 desks, and the children are happy. You know what made me mad this morning? We called on some of the youth in the community that we have finished the project. They should just clean up the classroom so that your children can have a clean environment to study. They're asking for 15,000. A stranger came to your community, I'm not from that community, spent over 6 million naira to renovate a school. Alright, the roofing alone cost about 2.5 million. To renovate a school for your children, but you cannot contribute your quota in cleaning the classroom. You think this is a failure. And this is one of the greatest problems we have in Nigeria. The young people in Nigeria are not willing to sacrifice for them to have a good life. The young people who are supposed to stand firm, to demand equality, to demand justice, have sold their birthrights. Just imagine, somebody came to your community, helped you renovate the school, your children were sitting on the floor in their classroom, there was rain beating them in the classroom, somebody came, gave you a new roof, gave them brand new ceilings, doors, windows, desks. We asked, cleaned up the classroom, they said, no, you have to give us money. That's very, very sad. It's a great problem in Nigeria. We're going to continue to advocate to ensure that many youths wake up from their slumber, because many of them are sleeping. Many youths are sleeping in Nigeria. It's a big problem we have. And we think that we can continue to speak to them so that they can have a change of heart. All right? So going further, please help me with water. All right, just give me one bottle. Eva water. So going further, if you are watching me on Instagram, you can go to Ambassador Dion Osage Facebook page and follow our live there. All right, I'm live on Facebook and live on Instagram. You can go to Ambassador Dion Osage page and follow us there. All right, if you are on Facebook, you can go to Instagram, go like and follow, because very soon we are going to be doing most of our work on Instagram. All right, so that's it. And going further, for those of you who know me, I am not a bad person. I am not a bad person, but a lot of persons like to take advantage of my kindness, which I do not think is fair. A lot of persons like to take advantage of my kindness. A few months ago in March, you will remember very well, I was in Canada where I interviewed one mega comrade, Eranomiho Edebe. He called himself officer, investigator, or whatever he called himself in America. I interviewed him on our live platform to talk about some of his vision. He said he wanted to become a governor, which is good. I think it's a beautiful thing for anybody to have an ambition to become a governor. Yes, it's your right, you know, but having a visionless vision, I don't want to use an offensive word so it doesn't seem like I'm insulting anybody, because I'm not here to insult anybody, you know. I think that if you have a vision, you have to pursue your vision, all right? Clement Edebe have told the people that he will be in Nigeria by August latest, and we are in September. Today is September 12. Edebe told his people that he is coming to Nigeria not later than August. August has passed, and Edebe still have not returned. Does that mean he's lying to his followers? Does that mean he's trying to deceive his followers? I don't know. What I do know is that Mr. Edebe should refund my money, because I contributed to the organization as a show of support. I supported with 1,000 naira. That's a lot of money, man. You understand? He should return my 1,000 naira with immediate effect if he knows that he is not going to run for that post. Like I said on my previous video on the interview, I told him that we do not believe in his cause. Until we are able to believe, we'll be able to support him more. We also mentioned on that video that we think that he is only creating peace because he wants people to support him. And I was right. Just 2 weeks after that, he went back again, insulting various persons and insulting me, especially a young, handsome Dion Osage, who have created a massive change in Edo State. Massive change in Edo State. You understand? So please, send this message to Eranomiho that I am giving him 7 days to return my 1,000 naira with immediate effect. Or the 1,000 naira will start having interest. I repeat, Eranomiho, return my 1,000 naira to a Godsend Foundation account, First Bank 3060544255, with immediate effect. What's up? How's this work? Hold the water again, you hold it before. Is that the best way to hold it? So you want? Yeah? How are you supposed to hold it?
Yes, sir.
So I don't know where your hands have been. Is your hands clean?
Yes.
Let me see your hands. Yeah? That's Asun Gladys. Go and get me a cup. You've already touched it. I cannot drink it like this. You know, you don't say all these babes. I'll let God know what they do with their hand. Mm-hmm. Alright, so a lot of people do not understand that you want to give somebody water, you're holding it here. It's very, very wrong. You have to hold it here, alright? Because if I put this in my mouth like this now, I don't know whether your hand don't touch some kind of things this morning. You know, she's an adult. She can do whatever she wants. Alright? So, please. Send a message to Mega Comrade Investigator Iran Amigo that he should man up if he knows he's not coming to run for his election that he has been getting a lot of donations from source in their group. They told me that they have raised over $40,000. Iran Amigo have raised about $40,000. Somebody from the group sent me that. So if he knows that he's not coming to run, he should start refunding those people who have supported the cause. Because if he doesn't, he has no right to talk about corruption. That's corruption. If they are giving you money for a certain cause to pursue your governorship election, if you are not going to run, it is the right thing to do to make an instant refund to those people who have supported you. This is not an insult, but I'm very, very sure that he's going to come out of life and start insulting. That is his way. You understand? I saw that he went to the Edo Convention in USA. By the way, the Edo Convention is a very, very big failure anyway. That is why I did not go this year. Since last year to this year, no achievements. Since last year to this year, no achievements. Excuse me. You understand here? Natasha,
I'm back.
What?
I'm back.
Okay. I need cup now.
Sir, I couldn't get a glass cup.
No, it's okay. I don't need glass cup. I'm a street boy now. That's Asun Gladisto. That's you. Yes. Igweme. Yes, uh-huh. Oh, yeah. Your water is very important. I drink a lot of water when I'm in Nigeria. I cannot drink the juice. I don't drink anything but water when I'm in Nigeria because the juice you drink here, don't try them all. Unless you want me to admit you. Alright, so I was speaking about the Edo Convention in USA. The Edo Convention in USA is a big, big failure. Mm-hmm. It's a big failure because in the last 28 years, they have not done anything productive. And that's a fact. In the last 28 years since the organization started, the Edo Convention in USA have not done anything productive. They said they built a park that was built by Oshogbo. Oshogbo built the park, but Oshogbo donated $120,000 to the organization. I was there. You understand? If Godsend Foundation can renovate a school, why can't Edo Convention USA do better? They have millions of naira in that organization. There's an Edo association in every state in USA. Every state in USA have at least about 3 cities minimum. So in 3 cities, let's assume there's Edo Commission in three cities in every state in the US. That's about 150 organizations. 3 times 50 states in America is 150 organizations. If each organization now say, you know what, we are going to give every month. And each organization, this is a small math, let's just do a small math. 50 states in America, right? Okay? Each state have about 3 Edo organizations. 3 Edo organizations. You multiply this, you have about 150 organizations that is under ENA. 150 Edo organizations that is under ENA. And each of these organizations have a member, at least 20 members minimum. 20 members minimum, okay, in each organization. All right, where's my phone? All right, somebody should multiply 20 members times 150 for me. Let's see. Okay, pull out a calculator for me. Okay, we're gonna do a small math for the Edo people in USA. Yeah, let's do a small math for them so that they understand that we are not just talking, we are making common sense, okay? I repeat, there are 50 states in America. Each state has a minimum of 3 cities, 3 major cities, and each of these cities has an Edo organization. All these Edo organizations are under ENA. All right? Now, for example, Texas. In Texas, we have Austin, we have Houston, we have Dallas, we have San Antonio, we have El Paso, we have every city. So let's say three cities minimum. Now, each of these cities has a Edo organization with at least 20 members. Lock that up. This is your phone, you're losing lock. I don't understand, but you had something. Right? Are you hiding? No. Last night at about 1 a.m., I sneaked into Love Doctor's room. This is my first time of seeing him starting with a woman. He was on live, was it live, on a video call with a woman. All right, so we have about 150 Edo organizations in USA, 150. So now multiply that times 20 members. Let's say minimum of 20 is more, but let's use 20 members, times 20 members. That's about 3,000 people, man. We have, let's just say about 3,000 people are members of Edo organization. Now, if 3,000 people just support the organization with just $10, $10, okay, multiply times $10. We have $30,000 every month. Each member of Edo organization, let's assume we have 3,000 members in the whole USA, supports the organization with $10, only $10, the cost of a hamburger every month, we're going to have $30,000. If you multiply $30,000 with the current exchange rate in Nigeria times 350 naira, we have 10.5 million naira every month. Alright, so I was saying that we have 10.5 million naira every month. If 3,000 members of Edo National Association in USA support their organization with just $10 every month, we have 10.5 million naira every month.
I'm back.
Alright, I think that the bad people are pushing, messing up our network because I'm trying to advise the Edo organization. Me, I'm a special advisor, man. I'm a special advisor on every matter. Alright, so Edo organization in USA can raise 10.5 million naira every month towards a project in Edo State. Now, this 10.5 million naira in a year, we're going to have roughly about 120 million, let's say 130 million naira every year. 130 million naira is big enough to do a massive project in every community. If you divide this 130 million naira into four places, you're going to have about 40 million, let's say 40 million each. 40 million can build three standard of, or a good standard school in Ovia, in Uwode. It's a common idea. So the leadership of the organization is a very, very fit leadership system that the organization need to think, what can we do? Okay, this Washington DC organization they had in Washington DC this year has passed. What project will they be able to achieve before the next event? That should be a project. So when people come to the organization and say, this year we built a school in Okada, or this year we built a school in Uwode, next year we are building a hospital, that's development. If a Godsend Foundation can renovate a school in less than 10 days, then what's the purpose of Edo Convention, Edo Association in America to gather every year, make a bunch of noise, wear a shoebi, meet your old pals, and many of these people that attend the events are professionals. We have doctors, we have lawyers, we have accountants, we have nurses who have failed to do something back home. Many of them don't come home. So please, if you cannot do the project, contact Dion Osage. I'm willing to help you guys execute a lot of projects. All you need to do is support. Alright? The Edo organization in USA should contact me. I am one of you guys. I have been to Edo Convention 7 years in a row. I stopped going when I see that the organization has no plan. I was in the one they did in Toronto last year. I paid my way there, I paid my hotel. But from last year to this year, there's no single project. Now, what is that? Maybe they come back home for free medical checkup. That's not a project. Sending doctors to Nigeria to do free blood tests and do that, that's not a project. There should be a massive project. There's nothing wrong with having Edo House Edo Diaspora House built by the Edo people in America. Let's take the same formula around the whole country where we have Nigerians, Italy, Germany, Spain, Austria, all over the world. We can build Edo. If we take the same formula of Edo organization doing a project in Edo, Edo State can be great. I want to use this medium to appeal to every Edo citizen who are leaders of various organizations to please reach back home, do something, talk to your members. Akube or Eti. Alright? So moving forward, I was taking a stroll the other day. There's a bus park not too far from here. There's a central bus park not too far from here. I was very, very hungry, man. I was very, very hungry to see that bus driver pay 800 naira. 800 naira to load every single day. And there are over 1,000 buses that load from there. If you have not seen that video, please allow me to show you that video. Allow me to show you that video if you have not seen it, so that you too can understand. The network is very bad today. I don't know why. Okay, this was when I interviewed the Ranamigo, by the way. So we know the two things. If you have not seen that video, go and see it. So that you understand that we are not just... Now let me say that it doesn't finish again. Let me show you guys. This is Central Park in Benin City. Central Park, where most of the bus load at. Nigeria, now we're talking nuggets. How far now, brother? Yeah. You're on your side. You send me your account number, man. I was actually looking for your number. Small Prince tried to reach you. Yeah, I'm in Benin now, yeah. Yeah, send it there. Are you on WhatsApp? Send it to WhatsApp on this number. Alright, so this is Central Park in Benin, where we have about 1,000 buses loading every day. It's a small mathematics. I have written so many proposals to the state government that they don't listen to me. So I just bring the idea that this is a proposal I wrote 2017, I believe. 2017, I did this proposal to the state government for Edo in diaspora. This was what I did. Unlock rich potential of Edo State for greater investment. Alright, this proposal I did. But many of them, look at it. I did this proposal on how the government can partner with the Edos in diaspora to make Edo great. But they always ignore. I've already went to look for partners. Look at the partners, proposed partners. The Oba Ewari Foundation, Ministry of Arts and Culture, Dangote, USAID, GLO, Europe Union, Edo State Government, FIRS, Best Western. Look at all the partners I have gathered. But they look at my proposal, they know that I can make a change, they drop it. Guess what? Less than 3 months ago, they did Edo Diaspora Summit in UK. About 10 persons came. But we did our own in Italy. Over 300 persons came from around the world. So until the government start believing in the youth, we cannot move forward. Now, the park is a total mess. And I'm very, very ashamed. After taking bus in Stratford bus station in London, I was in Houston bus station in London, I was in bus station in Valencia, I was in bus station in Torino. Coming back home to see that shit they call Central Bus Station is a total mess. And it's been like that for 3 years. This is not to criticize the governor, but it's a common sense. Now, here's a small mathematics. Hopefully they are watching it. You collect 800 naira from each bus every day. Somebody should do the math for me. Somebody pull out your calculator. You have a calculator there? Somebody pull out your calculator, please. Mr. Larry, open this. This is a small mathematics. There is no excuse for the state government to collect 800 naira from drivers, and they cannot fix up the park. All right, so we collect 800 naira every day times 1,000 buses, an average of 1,000 buses load in and out from there, because it's the central park. They go in there, pay and load every day. 1,000 buses multiplied by 800 a day, you have 800.
Drop it.
I'm back.
Huh? Okay, you can drop it and go and get it. Let's take a break.
Drivers pay 800 naira every day. The park makes about 800,000 naira. If you multiply 800 times 30 days, you will see how much you get. If you multiply 30 days, that total amount on 30 days times 12, you are running into millions, over 200 million naira. 200 million naira is enough, more than enough. With 50 million naira, we can create a standard bus park. All we need is good gravel, good cement. So I have made a proposal which I will be submitting with the state government to allow me to fix up the central park. I will build 10 restrooms, standard restrooms, because many of those bus drivers now, they, let me check on that. Okay, many of those cab drivers now, they take a shit every day. They take a pee every day. There's no restroom there. We can create 10 restrooms to generate revenue. We can create 10 restrooms to generate revenue. We can create a ticket office. Instead of those men coming and getting tickets, every bus that comes in there, like they do it in UK and other parts of Europe, you go to the counter, pay your ticket, and you pay for your ticket, and they give you your ticket. It's a total injustice that we collect 800 naira from our drivers every day in Benin, but the place where they work is a total mess. So we are going to be dropping a proposal to the state government to allow us fix up the bus park at no cost to the government. All we ask is give us 1 year to get our money back. We think it's very, very fair. With less than 50 million naira, we can have a standard park, and in a year, we can collect over 200 million. Yeah, we can collect over 200 million. And another initiative I have also proposed is we have Edo Public Safety Department, whereby the state can regularize those vehicles. There are so many vehicles on the street, no headlight, no wipers, no tires. This is a public safety issue. Those kind of vehicles should not be allowed to pick up any passengers. It should be a concern to the state that there are so many vehicles on the streets that is not fit for the road. Like in UK, we have MOT. In the UK, they have MOT where every year you go do your you go inspect your car. When I was in UK recently, I went with my friend JJ Berry to inspect his Range Rover. It did not pass because license plate light was off. Only the license plate. He has good tires, good wipers, good. Only the license plate light was the problem in the car, in the field. So compare that to a vehicles don't have tires, no wiper, no headlight, no brake lights. It's a very, very big hazard, and the state government should create Edo Department of Public Safety, because public safety should be a priority to the state government. I can do that project for the state at no cost, whereby every public vehicle is must go through an inspection. Every month, all we need to do is create a big compound. We'll hire some youth.
I'm back.
All right, sorry about the network issue, guys. So the public safety issue is very important. The state government, we're going to propose to them. I know that they are not going to listen to us. They should give us a department whereby we inspect every public vehicle where they pay a token, even if it's just 200 naira, once a month. That can create jobs. You bring your vehicle there, we're going to make sure that your tires are good, your headlight is working, your horn is working, your wipers are good, your brake light is good, like they do in Europe, America, and other parts of the world. Majority of the drivers who drive those buses do not even have a driver license. It's a very, very big issue in those states that needs to stop. I wish that they give us an opportunity to lead our people, man, because many initiatives can be created to better Edo State. Two things I mentioned now to the state government. Fix the bus park. If you don't fix it, give it to me. I will fix it to standard. Collect fees for a year. Create a department of public safety whereby we inspect every public vehicle in Edo State to make sure that our people are not in hazard. We also need to visit the commissioner of police to address the issue of the Edos in diaspora being harassed every time they come home. By the grace of God, we'll be able to do that next week. We're going to make a meeting with the commissioner of police. The Edos in diaspora are not safe when they come home. They are harassed by SARS, calling them Yahoo boys. Because a young man came back home, bought a car, should not warrant to the steady harassment. So we need to create an office here in Godsend Foundation whereby all the adults in diaspora can now lay their complaint to our office here and we can address it to the Commissioner of Police. Because the harassment to adult youths from diaspora is becoming too much. Everybody is a Yahoo boy. So it's very, very unfair. So we are working on that on behalf of all Godsend family and the adults in diaspora. We're going to have a meeting. We're going to go live with you to talk to the Commissioner of Police that we need an office or a person we can complain to every time they harass the adults in diaspora. Many adults in diaspora do not come back home because they are afraid that they are going to be harassed. When you are in Lagos, nobody harasses you, man. But why is it that every time people come to Benin, before they drive from Ring Road to Sakoba Road, police put them over, bring your paper, give us money. It's becoming too much and we need to address that. So I'm standing between the gap for the adults in diaspora and the commissioner of police that we must ensure that the adults in diaspora are given a fair chance to live in Edo. And also the custom officer at Oluku is another big issue. When you go to Oluku right now, you see a lot of containers packed in the road. Why would a person pay over 1 million naira to bring goods to Edo State? Why would a person pay over 1 million naira to bring goods to Edo State after they leave from Lagos, getting to Benin, they still not start paying more money? It's very, very unfair. So the state government should address the issue of the steady harassment of the Edo people who are bringing goods to the state. They are depriving Edo people from doing business in Edo State. It should not be this way. We should encourage our brothers and sisters in diaspora to bring more goods back home so that people can buy products, the money can circulate. Now, the Edos in diaspora are bringing goods and selling them in Lagos. Nobody wants to come to Benin. Another proposal that I also gave was the government should create Edo in diaspora market. Edo in diaspora market can function very, very well if the government approve it. All we ask for is for the government to give us land. We create this land as a very, very big park with high security and stores. The adults in diaspora, instead of you taking your container to the roadside to offload, you can come there. Once you come there, we'll give you a hall. You can put your things there. And once a week, we can have Adult Diaspora International Market Day, where you can sell your fridge, you can sell your TV, you can sell your used clothes, and things like that. So there are so many ways we can better Edo, but they know that Genosage have so many bright ideas, but they are not giving us a fair chance. What's wrong with creating public, mobile public restroom? We can create that. around Ring Road, we can create mobile restroom. I've looked it up already. Look at it, guys. It's very, very easy. It's right here. You know, we just hope that one day somebody that understands what we're trying to do for those states can reach out to us to make all this dream work. Mobile restroom, mobile toilets. You know, instead of people peeing around the city center, we can have mobile toilets around the city center where people can pay just a little fee. Look at this. This is a mobile toilet. There's no toilet around Ring Road. There's no public toilet. Let me show you guys. All right. This mobile toilet, it's calling me. This mobile toilet costs around about roughly about 40,000 naira per one. All right. With this mobile toilet, we can generate more than 40,000 naira per one every month by charging just 20 naira to use it. This can create jobs. We have each one. We have somebody working there. Yeah. We can have maybe 10 around Ring Road. We can have some in New Benin. We can have some in Mission Road, so that people can learn the habit of using restroom instead of putting their stinking dick on the road. So much to do to make a dog great. All right, going further, I listened to Eddie Murphy last broadcast 2 days ago, where he actually said everything that happened between him, Prince Gion, and Omedel. If you have not seen that video, I want you to go and see it. Prince Igeon used to be still a very good friend of mine. I love him so much because of his attitude. And Omede was also part of the people who hosted me when I was in Germany, in Hagen. When I visited Hagen, Omede was one of the persons who hosted me there, and I respect them so much, even till tomorrow. But what I don't respect is anyone secretly planning to assassinate someone like Joe Saigi. Not assassinate to kill me, but assassinate my character. We think it's very, very unfair for those Edo people in diaspora who are supposed to protect our common goals, our interests, are planning behind on how to make us look bad. It is not nice. Omede and Igeon called Eddie Murphy to tell Eddie Murphy to start calling people's name that they are enemies of the palace. This is the palace. The palace is a walking distance from here. Like I told my followers before, I told you, if the palace wants me, they know how to get me. More than 60% of the young people that work in the palace are my friends. And I told my gossip family, no, see like that. Many of them did not believe me. Many of them did not come to the reunion we had because they believed that I was truly wanted by the palace. Omede Anigion was able to convince the Edo populace that we are enemy of the great Benin Kingdom, a kingdom that we project every day, a kingdom that we are so proud of. I am the only man that has massive picture of the Oba of Benin in his office. I'm the only man that project culture. Why would I become an enemy of the kingdom? So it was all lies, just trying to spoil my character. And it's very sad. I called Igeon when I was in Canada to say, my brother, this is what I heard. Igeon said, no such thing, that he didn't hear that. That no, he can never do that. I called Omede. Omede said the same thing. All right? But I now found out that Omede was involved, because when I was trying to call Omede, he used to be my friend on WhatsApp. I looked up his number on WhatsApp. I want so bad, even today, I think I'm still blocked. Look at him here. He's right here. This is his number. Okay, I think I'm still blocked. So, okay, look at him. So when I was in Canada, I tried to call I want so bad on my WhatsApp. The number was not going. I looked for him on Facebook. The Facebook was blocked. I went to my wife's phone and tried to look at his number. The number was there. So I automatically knew that he was involved in it. Because I tried to call him directly on my phone, on my WhatsApp. Okay? I tried to call him directly on my WhatsApp. It was not going through. I tried to call him on Facebook. It was not going through. But his WhatsApp was still on. So when I called him, I was like, hey, Papa, who blocked him on WhatsApp? Did you block me on WhatsApp? Well, he said, no, I have issues with my son, which was a lie. And I find out that the reason he was beefing me was because I spoke about the Royal Army Organization, which he is one of the founder. Because when I made a post that I was going to talk about Royal Army some months back, he called me and said, no, don't say anything about Royal Army. Royal Army is a valid organization and all that. But I still went ahead and said that the Royal Army was a fake organization because I already made my contact in the palace. I already called the palace to ask, is there anything about like Royal Army? They said they don't know anything like that. Which Iguion also confirmed to me that the palace is exactly what Palace Mai, Palace Seji Mai. What Iguion told me when I called him. You understand? So trying to bring down your brother, who you see is doing massive good for the kingdom, is very, very uncalled for. Because you are a chief, or maybe because you are close to the palace, or know one or two persons in the palace, and they are giving you authority to oversee the Edo people in diaspora, doesn't give you the right to try to spoil me. Who God has blessed, no man can curse. You have seen. Alright, so who God has blessed, let no man curse. Edo people should learn how to get along, be your brother's keeper. I was told that the same Omede, who was even, this is a true story, my dude in Italy, Dandy, called me and told me that he has spoke to Omede to kindly let things go. That Omede was saying, no, Jono Sagi must go to the palace to drink water. In fact, I would be so glad to go drink the water. Because any water I drink from the palace is water of grace. Even Dandy in Italy, Torino, told me that he has apologized. He's all
back.
Now, wow, internet. Alright, so, you know, going further, I don't want to talk too much. I'm not the type that I like to dwell on the past. Oh, wow. Alright, so the internet is very bad. I just want to say that for those of you who have hurt me indirectly or directly, once again, I forgive you. But please, let us all gather along and make Edo great. You know, make Edo great. Let us all get along. Make Edo great. I forgive you, Omede, for planning evil against me. Prince Iguion, I also forgive you.
I'm back.
You are back again. Okay, the internet is messing up today. I think we have been able to address what we needed to address. We are going to support Eddie Murphy's event. Eddie Murphy, we are coming to your city. We are going to be at your end of year party. Me, myself, and I, let's put it that way. But my friend Skimiya will be there. I think Destiny Ebagwa will also be there. I have created my own special banner for you. Okay? This is it, Edo Reality. Right here, capture this. You got it? Alright, Edo Reality anniversary party coming on 5th of October, 5 p.m. to 6 a.m. morning. Alright, and the second will be there. I will send this to social media president to put on his wall. Because when people show an attitude of a better tomorrow, then we too need to support them. You understand? I keep telling you guys that Eddie Murphy is not a bad person. I keep telling you that me at the seafront. I keep telling you that Eddie Murphy is not a bad person. Okay. And that's that. Okay, so to all the Godsend family, I want you to forgive and forget. Forgive but don't forget. Don't forget. I don't want to see any negative talk about Igion or Omede. I don't want to see any negative talk about those two persons. Alright? God will continue to fight our fights. Let everybody shine their shine. Let me shine my shine. According to Monica. Lobo, lobo. Alright, so I think that tomorrow we are going to go live at the God Sent Foundation. It's going to be a fundraising for tomorrow. We're going to do a fundraising because we need a lot of money to do our projects. On Saturday, we're going to take it to Umuduba Kingdom, where we are having our New Yam Festival. I will be representing as Chief Omeroha of Umuduba Kingdom at Isu Local Government in Imo State. That's going to happen on Saturday. Be on the lookout at about 3 p.m. We'll bring you live on Saturday. On Sunday, we're going to have a chill. On Monday, we are going to open the school in Aduohun Primary School. Then on Tuesday, I'll keep you posted on that. Okay? So every day is a progress and the movement continues. If you are not busy, stay tuned. In the next 30 minutes, we are going to be showing you a property we recently acquired right here in Ring Road, Benin City, right behind the Obaseki family house. We are going to be showing you a property right behind the road, right inside of the Obaseki house, family house. We recently acquired a property there that we are going to be marketing. This is the middle of the city, and this place can be used for down there. We can use this place for like stores. We can use it for offices. We can use it for a warehouse, or we can use it for so many projects. We can use it as a, let's assume we build 30 room stores. All right, we can, four persons can come together to have this building, and we can split the store. So let's assume four persons build this building. Each of us can have about let's say about six or seven stores for a lifetime.
How's it going? I'm done. It's working.
Alright, so just join me in about 30 minutes. I will show you a property around the Benin City Center. It's a great investment for all of our brothers and sisters who they like to do Euro to Euro business, who like shopping center. This will be a very, very good investment for you to invest in. So I will take you to that property right away and you can take a look at it. I think you will love it. It's a good investment. Just come and look at it. I'll see you again. All right. Note: do not insult Omede.